Hello everyone, today we're going to talk about service mesh and how to integrate that with our GSLB Edge DNS feature in order to provide automatically access to application without having to configure anything on the DNS and or the GSLB load balancer. So first of all, a small diagram of what we are using right now. It's the service mesh of Hashicorp named Consul. And here we are using, in order to run our containers, we are using Nomad from Hashicorp as well because it's very easy. And we don't need to deploy a very large infrastructure like we could do with Kubernetes. And the interesting part is here on the diagram on starting at step three, where our DNS GSLB listening to the console event will automatically create and destroy DNS records and application and pool and nodes within GSLB to make this application available for the user. So let's start with console. So console here is started with a certain amount of nodes. I got three master nodes and five slaves just for this demo. So keep in mind that any service that I will start within Nomad will run on one of the five slaves. And here, in terms of services in our service mesh, we have nothing else but the infrastructure. So we have Consul and we have Nomad within this infrastructure. On the Nomad part, the principle of Nomad is to be able to start and stop services running on our slave nodes, and it runs with various engines. It can run with Docker or containers, and can run Java as well or specific binaries. Here we are using Docker images, and just to show you, I'm going to start a simple web app which here is running with various instances. It's to show you how it runs and how it connects to console to say it's available. So we do have our web app starting, and within console we will see these web apps started. It's starting to pop up. So here our web app is starting with four slaves, and each slave is running on one of the node. Obviously they are numbered very easily here, and each application has provided a service health check in order for the console to know if the service is running. So for the time being, this application is not available from the outside world. It's running on specific and random port numbers that you can show here. So no option to get access to this, because on our firewall, we have opened only few ports. And the idea is to be able to get access to this web app through a reverse proxy that we will start just afterwards. Last point is on the EfficientIP side, where on the application module we have started already two applications, one to get access to our console and one to get access to our Nomad user interface. So when I got access to both GUI for console and Nomad, I'm still using the GSLB of my solid server. So now let's start the interesting part of our service. It's the one which will be exposed. So the traffic service that I've defined is going to start right now. And when it will start, it will register to the console. So let's have a look to our console to see that in the services. So now I've got traffic traffic reverse proxy running on one node is running on a node named slave one, and it's provided also a service check. And this is this event, the creation of this traffic service on one node that has been listened by our GSLB engine. So here within the GSLB we have a new application, traffic test, that has been automatically built with a pool and with one node, the slave one node, that make this reverse proxy and then the application behind available. So right now I should get access to my traffic engine. I'm going to show you that. So let's switch on the traffic. So here is my traffic engine, the dashboard of this reverse proxy, on which I have one application which is registered. That's the backend I've started on my four nodes that has shown that are shown here. And this traffic is exposed on an endpoint with a specific URL, which is here /myapp. So should be able to get access to this web page right here using the name that has been configured in the GSLB. And the traffic is load balanced on all the nodes, on the four nodes where this web app is running right now. So the interesting part is that the creation of the application and all the pools and all the nodes has been directly performed by listening to the events of Consul. So let's move on. I'm gonna start a new instance on my traffic. So I've got only one instance right now. I'm gonna show you how to easily add an instance to this one, or let's say two instances. So I'm gonna start now two more instances. I'm gonna go from 1 to 3 on my traffic reverse proxy. So let's start these engines, which are running in containers. So now I got three instances running. Let's have a look in the console part if everything has been effectively registered for traffic. Yeah, it seems that I have effectively my engine running, and they're running on slave 1, 2, and 4 this time. So that's not the same slaves as the one running the web app. And if I have a look to the GSLB module, should get here the two additional nodes. Started with 1 and now I have 2 and 4 available as a service. For sure, I still get access to my traffic backend and probably to my traffic frontend. Should not have been stopped. And the traffic is going from one node to another. If you want to be sure about the DNS part of it, so I'm gonna ask directly to the DNS for my service, which is named traffic-test.consul.test. That's the domain I've used for my testing. And here, if I do multiple requests, I go from one node to the other. 34, 54, 34, 54. So I do round robin between my my different slaves to get access to the node. For sure, whenever we decide to scale down the number of services we are using, for example, let's go down to two reverse proxies, then one of the nodes will be suppressed for the traffic engine within the console. So it already has disappeared. And within the EfficientIP GSLB configuration, where one of the nodes disappeared. by extent if we do suppress the whole service, we will not have any more anything in Consul. The slaves have the application has disappeared, so I don't have any more my traffic reverse proxy. Still have the web application, and within my GSLB, the application has disappeared. I still have my Consul and Nomad user interface access, but not anymore the service I have started. So that's it. So it was a short introduction of service mesh and how it works with our GSLB. If you like it, don't hesitate to say it, put comments, and subscribe to our channel for the next recording of this kind of demonstration. Bye bye.